Ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen and ladies, ladies and gents, the one thing you can't take away from this man, through all of his problems, through all of the things he's been through, that fool could sing. Well, I didn't say sing, I said bang! So can the other two horns with them. Gentlemen, I gotta take us down a little bit. That was yesterday that I had it up that loud, but we gotta take it on down, ladies and gentlemen. Got James Brown, we got Prince, and we got Michael Jackson. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to show you something. This has not been altered. This has not been amended. This has not been tampered with. I want you to see the portfolio. It's not complete. They never completed it. They were going to complete it. And we are just letting you know. Now, they's going to be, that was 2 days ago. They's going to be pissed off at what I'm about to tell y'all. Because they saw the amount of tax credits, and because some of y'all been paying attention to how to file your applications, and they heard the video about filing applications, they knew I was on my way. That's my Fidelity account. They just shut down the account yesterday. Fidelity, FedEx, and UPS. And Amazon, sorry, Fidelity, FedEx, UPS, UPS and Amazon are together. And Fidelity, FedEx, UPS, Amazon. Those are my best friends. And I'm about to show them what friendship is all about. Ladies and gentlemen, say lady! I'm going to step away from the computer for a moment because I'm sauteing some vegetables and fish. And while I'm sauteing my vegetables and my fish, and I ain't burning nothing tonight, I want to tell you guys something about the new SATCOMM program. Because we told you guys we were working on something. Ladies and gentlemen, what I can tell you for a certainty is no one has done this before. And I have run it by several people. In confidence, because we don't want anybody thinking that they're going to mess up things for everybody else like they almost attempted to do with arbitration and so many other things. We got people who were taking our SAT packs and trying to reproduce and recreate individual morons who were taking and filing their documents looking like our stuff in the same county we were filing ours in. As if they were doing something great. Didn't understand the reason why we were doing it in the first place. So you guys are just going to have to bear with me. As I explain this. There will be a contract. Limited power of attorney. There will be a trust. Which you will be the beneficiary. Technically you will also be the grantor. Settler, grantor, trustor. Same thing. Don't care what anybody says. Just the way it is. The organization will be the trustor involving several aspects. We'll be documenting certain things about your property. We'll be filing certain things on the record. We'll be filing certain things in another location which you will not be privy to. Yeah, that's the part that the law says. That's why we will be acting as trustees so that we don't have to tell you that. And the reason why we're not going to tell you is because everybody bites. They come and they take what doesn't belong to them. We cannot afford to let people take from us. Not this time. Because we're trying to help as many people as possible. This will involve individuals who are pre-foreclosure, the individuals who are not anywhere near foreclosure, and the individuals who are going through foreclosure. We will be stepping up to help each But remember, I need y'all to understand, there's only one of me. Oh, thank God. Oh, thank God. Ooh, can you imagine if there was three or four of that motherfucker? Wait, Lord, no. Lord, no. Don't do that to us. Look here, you ignorant mother. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, this is not a company video. We'll be putting those up soon. Look, I haven't had the time, ladies and gentlemen, because I've been trying to literally brainstorm about this and figure out a way of helping everybody. I can't help everybody if I'm helping everybody. I can't brainstorm about this if I can't help everybody. I spent more than 7 hours on the phone today, and that includes a consult where the young man, he literally thought he had already been foreclosed on, and he hadn't. The judge was only determining that they could sell his home. And so during that conversation, I told him, suggested to him what he should do. And sure enough, he's going to do it. Will I tell it to the rest of you? No, because I don't trust you, mother. I'm sorry. I'm telling the truth, though. I might be joking, but I'm telling the truth. Hey, if y'all want to know how much the joke that I am right now, go and listen to Bill Bellamy talk about the Jamie Foxx thing. The Jamie Foxx and LL Cool J. Okay? Bill Bellamy does a, what you call it, where he's talking about, let's see if I can pull it up. Hold on. Yeah, let's go with this one. Oh, no, we can't play that. Hold on. Can't play that. I forgot. I downloaded a bunch of songs off YouTube. Woo! Can't play that one. I'm glad I was cleaning out my ears when that happened. Woo-wee! Can't play that one. D'Angelo, I don't trust you. Mint condition, I can handle y'all. Woo! I was supposed to be watching that. I apologize, y'all. I almost played. How you do that there? And I could not do that to y'all. Because I cannot do that, ladies and gentlemen. But we're going to do Pretty Brown Eyes by Mint Condition, ladies and gentlemen. And some of y'all can go there with me. Okay? The way you treat me. Ladies and gentlemen, what I wanted to do is I was going to show you, but it hasn't pulled up. And something is interfering. I am down to 4 gigabytes, and let's build up some memory. Let's build up some memory so that I can move forward. We're going to go ahead, and we're going to do a flat rate of $1,500, and we really couldn't help everybody because a lot of people, they don't have any money. No matter how many videos I do telling them how they should be able to get money. And that's happening because of this right here. Because I was at 4.5. Now I'm at 7.5. That's what that does. And I need that, ladies and gentlemen. Because that's to make sure that we are smooth through the rest of the video. Okay. Now, as you notice, that didn't pull up. So let's see if we can pull this up. But anyway, if you want to know how much of a joke I am, go back and listen to Bill Bellamy talk about Jamie Foxx getting knocked out by LL Cool J. Oh, he... sorry, it's hilarious! He was there! And I'm sorry, you just have to know Jamie's personality and Todd Smith, LL Cool J's personality. And I know. It's not the same as it was then. I know that there's not the animosity they had back then, okay? But when Bill Bellamy tells you this story and he puts it on YouTube so that everybody and their grandmama can know, you'll understand that he ain't got no reason to lie. So it's a hilarious story. But what I'm trying to say is LL Cool J wasn't joking the same way someone else was joking. And so when LL Cool J joked his way, the other person decided to sleep on it. Okay, I mean, that's the best way I can explain it, okay? And so what I'm trying to tell you guys is I was not around the last time, and people took more than advantage. We warned them, including a guy who I told, hey, you're using our stuff and you're selling our stuff. You don't get to sell our stuff. We haven't given you permission to sell what belongs to us. But by the way, ladies and gentlemen, he was selling the arbitration agreement that he downloaded from our site. He wasn't changing anything. Well, see, I created those documents. Well, didn't you say if it has statutes and codes in it that it's not copywritten? Well, ladies and gentlemen, up to certain levels and up to certain points, that is true. But the problem is, this individual was taking the arbitration notifications, the arbitration information. That was ours. Didn't have any statutes and codes in that. And they were charging people for it. A lot of people were taking documents from our site and charging people to have access to it. Ladies and gentlemen, we put it up there for free. And they're getting greedy. Tell me, what sense does that make? Sorry, ladies and gentlemen, I'm over here cooking, but I'm also at the door and I'm looking at Penny and Max. And they play kind of rough. And so Penny and Max are out there wrestling with each other. And so I'm sitting up here with the door open watching them on this cool evening because it was over 100 degrees today. So let me go ahead and finish explaining this to some of you. Ladies and gentlemen, many people have been watching the video telling people about the bill of exchange in the application or the promissory note in the application. Many of you are not understanding. They already have the rules and regulations in place. Okay, I'm going to tell you guys what I told the other guy today when I was doing the consult so that you guys can better understand it. Let's go. I'm hoping this is it. No, that's the judge, so I got to open it. Now, I want to let you know that I did correct something on a document so we can kill two birds, one stone. And romance. Ladies and gentlemen, it's pretty brown eyes by mint condition. I just gotta wait for this to open up. That's what happens when I'm doing all this stuff, because you see I dropped 2 gigabytes just because of the video and the audio. So let me pause y'all so I can have some space. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sorry, I'm even laughing now. Bill Bellamy curses, okay? So be prepared for that. I'm sorry. Ladies and gentlemen, he just did one recently, but this is the one I watched, okay? How Jamie Foxx got knocked out by LL Cool J. Like I told you, he had to sleep on it. He doesn't show any pictures. He just describes it, okay? And all I can tell you is LL Cool J used to be the guy who got picked on. He used to be the thin guy. And so the weights and a couple other things he used to bulk up. And this young man, I'm sorry. And that's what Bill Bellamy is saying. And he tried to warn Jamie. So, ladies and gentlemen, I'm only mentioning that for this reason only. Sorry, I had to open this up again. I cannot allow people to keep taking advantage of me. No, I'm a Jehovah's Witness. I don't do the violent stuff. Okay? I don't know who this is, so I gotta be careful. Like I said, I don't play no cursing. Who is this? Hold on. Pause. This looks like it's LTD. But I don't know. I can't tell. I gotta open it up. Come on now. LTD. Cutting it up. Okay, I can deal with LTD because they feature my boy James. But see, we got Master P and all of them. I ain't playing that. You know what I mean? We can do the Gap Band and all of them, but you know, I just can't, because I downloaded and complete an entire mix, and that's the problem. So I have to be careful. You be careful. All right, So what I'm going to show you guys, many of you should already know. So this is, as a matter of fact, hey, thank you guys from LTD. I have to take you and turn you off because I need to show something to the people. So y'all have to excuse me for a moment. It will be too big of a distraction showing this to you guys. Okay. Too big of a distraction. Give me a second, ladies and gentlemen. I'm not going to put y'all on pause. I just have to walk over to the skillet to make sure that I stir my fry, because it is stir fry. Okay.
Stir fry Friday?
Stir fry Tuesday. Okay. I had this last night. And you're not going to believe it, but I had it for breakfast and I'm having it for dinner. So that is 3 meals in a row that I'm doing stir fry. And I promise you, I wouldn't be doing it if it wasn't that good. I told you, I'm a fan of my own cooking. You got to give my mother her credit because she's the one who taught me. And as I said before, everybody, all of my friends would come to my house to eat. So I don't mind. I don't do it no more. I don't do a lot of cooking no more. I mean, I cook, but only for me. I don't cook for other people. That's right. Not even for you. So shut it up. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let me show you something. So that, and while I'm doing this, pull up Title 14. I'm not going to pull up Title 14. It's not my, I mean, Title 14, Title 12, Section 412. Pull that up while I'm reading this. So that you guys can see what's going on.
Uh-oh, that's too large, Sonny.
Don't worry about what's too large and what's not too large. You just focus on you. You let me do me. You do you, I'ma do me, all right? All right? Then so be it. Then get on about your business and get out of mine. Ladies and gentlemen, I need y'all to pay attention to the Federal Reserve Act. That's what this is. It says Federal Reserve Act as amended. Upon deposit. What is deposited? Pay attention. Direct obligations of the United States or notes. So upon deposit of the note, acquired under provisions of this act, application. They're applying the act, application. Any Federal Reserve Bank may make such a deposit that is you in a manner prescribed by the Treasury. And shall be entitled to receive from the comptroller of the currency circulating notes in blank. Ladies and gentlemen, if you look at Section 411, the circulating notes are now Federal Reserve notes. Before, it was Federal Reserve bank notes. It's now Federal Reserve notes. They changed it, I believe it was 1945. They didn't start really using Federal Reserve notes. Now remember, it's not to be used by anyone else other than a member bank of the Federal Reserve. Well, if you look up the definition of member bank under Title 12, it means any bank. Just go ahead. Look, it's section 221. So Title 12, 221. You'll see under the second paragraph, member bank means any bank. You are a bank. You make deposits. You're involved, engaged in banking business. Doesn't matter. What type of banking business, just as long as you're engaged in it. When you give them your promissory note, this document is highlighted now. It's changed because we did an amendment to it. We corrected a spell error that I said I was going to correct months ago. So it's up on AmeriLegion and SATCOMM. It's called the New Deal. Subject to such limitations and restrictions and regulations as the Federal Reserve Board may prescribe.
Any
Federal Reserve. So that means any bank, any membered bank that includes you. Whenever it's not specific, any is as least specific as you can possibly get. Any implies any bank. Look up the definition for a Federal Reserve bank, and it'll give you the definition for bank. Whenever it says any bank, it's not specific. It means any bank, including you. Any, so we don't even have to read Federal Reserve. We can just go straight to bank. May make advances to an individual. Okay, pay attention. On the promissory note of such individual. Pay attention. Secured directly by obligations of the United States. Excuse me. How do you secure your promissory note by obligation of the United States? when you attached the stupid application and you deposited with the Federal Reserve agent. Go back and look at 212. And notice this. Such advances shall be made for periods not exceeding 90 days. That's why the banks, under the Truth in Lending Act, give you a provisional credit. Go and take a look. They give you a provisional credit. Why do they give you a provisional credit? Because it will take the Treasury, with so many people in America, up to 90 days to pay off that note. That's why you heard some people talking about it could take up to 90 days. Okay? Just understand it. That's the system. That's where they're getting it from. Now, mind you, so that you guys will fully get what's going on, because I know you still don't get it, so let's take a look down here. So you'll get section 412. Pay attention to 412. Read it while I'm reading this. Just the top portion. We have provided that any direct obligation of the United States or any note acquired by the Federal Reserve Bank may be deposited with the Federal Reserve agents. Forget about the Treasury of the United States. We're going to focus on with the Federal Reserve agent. Do you not deposit your application and your note with the Federal Reserve agent? And upon these collateral securities, Federal Reserve notes are issued. In the case of deposits of obligations of the government issued, the issue of Federal Reserve notes may be for the entire amount. Go back and look at Section 412 and see if this is not Section 412. Hold on. Beep, 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 beep. In the case of deposits, notes, Federal Reserve banks may issue Federal Reserve notes. Federal Reserve banks may issue Federal Reserve notes. Didn't say the controller of the currency. Didn't say the Treasury. Federal Reserve banks may issue Federal Reserve notes in the amount of 90% of the value of such securities. See, these are collateral securities. They call them collateral securities, even though they didn't call it that in the act. They call them collateral securities. Hold on, let's go find out what a collateral security is so that y'all get it. Because I still know that y'all still ain't getting it. So, let's see. We're going to go here. We're going to open up a new window. We're going to do, come on now, stop hitting the wrong button. Sorry, my fingers are not the smallest ones in the world. And S-E-C-U-R-I-T, where we got a definition? No, I don't want collateral security loans. Hold on. I don't want the loans, so we're just going to do... Collateral security is any other security offered for the said credit facility. Does anybody know what a credit facility is? You're wrong. It's not talking about a building. The facility is the instrument. Okay, security offered for the said credit instrument. For example, hypothecation of jewelry, mortgages for houses, etc. Examples, land, plant, machinery, and or any other business property in the name of the proprietor or unit of unencumbered can be taken as the primary security. Well, collateral security is taken as the primary security. Ladies and gentlemen, collateral security is what your promissory note is. It is the primary security. So why are you guys letting them foreclose on your homes? Your homes were not the security for the loan. So what we're going to be doing is there will be a non-disclosure agreement with all of our clients. Sorry, we have no other choice but to do that. The non-disclosure agreement, and it won't be $1,500 up front. We figure people cannot handle that, even though that's the work that's being done. We're going to do a flat fee, but realize that that won't be available to everyone. So we're going to do $580. Why $580? Why $580? Because that's going to be the discounted rate. Now, while we're doing 580, we're going after the credits. We're going to let you know. That's our discounted rate. Same thing. I decided to employ the same program as AmeriLegion. We're going to do the discounted rate. And while we're doing the discounted rate, there is also going to be a part of the agreement that whatever funds are recovered up to 5 years, we are going to take 50%.
What? That's different. That's up.
Well, let me do it this way. Go ahead and tell me what is 50% of nothing. So if funds are recovered, it's because of what we're doing. And if we're recovering those funds, 50% for 5 years, let's say you've been in the property for 10 years, you get 100% for the other 5 years. You get 50% for the first 5 years. 5 years is what we're taking. And we're taking 5 years on the tail end. So the last 5 years, not the first 5 years, of the funds recovered. Well, what if you haven't paid for the last 2 years? Then we only take 50% for the last 5 years. Do you not understand? Many of you haven't paid for the last 3 years. Some people haven't paid for the last 9 years. But you don't get it. So while you're huffing and puffing, we don't do something to get rich. We're not trying to get rich off of anybody. We're trying to help people. So that program will be started at the beginning of right around October 12th, October 15th. We will keep you up to date. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm spending time doing this video tonight as tired as I am. I haven't even eaten yet. I ate breakfast this morning. I haven't ate lunch. Okay. This is my dinner. It's 7:19. I'm tired. And I got to get up at 5 o'clock tomorrow morning. Again, I am tired. I have a reason for being tired. And I'm going to be tired because I ain't got no other choice. With that being said, ladies and gentlemen, so that y'all get it, because you need to get something, understand what collateral security is. Understand that you tendered collateral security. Understand that collateral security is tender. Understand that collateral security is tender. There is so much information in just this video that if y'all paid attention. Okay? Now, again, this document right here is called the New Deal. Go and get the one that's up now, because when you get down to Presidential Proclamation 2039, it said rule instead of roll. Okay, I'd even get this notarized, ladies and gentlemen. Pay attention. I put a Gerard on it and everything because it says right here. Hold on, got to lower it, got to decrease it. Okay, right here. I hereby declare that I accept the role as a banking institution during the ongoing and substantiated national emergency, that I accept the suspending of all normal banking activities and elect to utilize Section 401 of the Federal Reserve as amended by the 1933 Congress on March 9th, referring to Section 18, Paragraph 6 of the Federal Reserve Act and Section 4 of the March 1933 Act, and page 78 through 83 of the Congressional Record of the first session of the 73rd Congress, stating as irrefutable evidence as to what the law is. And then we put statutes at large, this wonderful Congress, which talked about the alien property custodian and the reversionary interest and full acquittance and discharge. I take a look at what you got here. Then we put Presidential Proclamation 2039. Ladies and gentlemen, this information is for your benefit. Some of you need to go over it several times so you can understand. We even put the Act of Congress talking about the Emergency Act, March 9, 1933. This is the actual act. So we have the record, we have the act. Then we put the Federal Reserve Act as amended right there. Then we put the War Powers Senate report, showing that these acts are still binding, still enforceable. Since 1933, the United States has been in a state of declared national emergency. Since 1933, so it's still ongoing. And then they talk about how unconstitutional it was for Congress, normally exercised by Congress, given to the president. Congress cannot give any other branch of government its authority. So pay attention. Hey, gotta go. That's 30 minutes. We gotta stop at 30.